What's up, everybody, and welcome back to our Life is Strange community series. I am Alex, and this is a community series and a series of videos where we talk about Life is Strange topics. We've done a bunch of topics on Life is Strange, really leading up to Life is Strange 2, and now we're finally here. Life is Strange 2 is out. It's out to the masses, and now we get to talk about basically what we found in Life is Strange 2, and we get to start predicting future episodes, and we get to do a ton of topics like that. This community series is going to be going on straight through Life is Strange 2, so we're going to be continuing this community series all throughout the second game. So for several months we'll be doing this. In this video I want to start out kind of political, kind of risky, and I want to kind of tiptoe about it. I want to make some clear points. I don't want to offend people, but I want to do this first, and there are other videos I do want to make about the first episode of Life is Strange, maybe some comparison stuff, and talking about Life is Strange 2 Episode 2 as we get closer. So, you know, if you saw the title, I want to talk about why Life is Strange 2 so far, and what it has seems to be anti-Trump. Now, the Don't Nod is from France. They're a French developer. They're the ones who make the game. So they're not American, but I think it couldn't be more clear in the game that they have a strong anti-Trump, anti-what's been going on over the past 2 years in America viewpoint. Now, we're not going to discuss sides of if you're with him or if you're not, but I just want to talk about, you know, the fact that it does seem to be that way. And there's a couple reasons for that. One is the season, or what it looks to be, the characters are definitely going a lot on the idea of the illegal immigrants, the whole racism kind of in our country, and they're playing a side. I think they're definitely playing a side, but you know, I do want to voice an opinion that I definitely think it's unfair the way that Don't Nod has done it in terms of just what we've seen so far. You know, they kind of have made, I mean, well, firstly, they showed the whole cop thing. So there has been, you know, over the past several years, we have heard many stories of the cops all across the country making pretty big mistakes and doing questionable calls and all that stuff. And that's no different. This cop, you know, if you saw the gameplay even before Life is Strange 2 Episode 1 came out, you would have seen that, you know, what happens. And that cop definitely is really like just the most over-exaggerated, not really. I mean, there have been videos and there have been, you know, times where cops have made those stupid choices. But it does seem to be the highest level of the wrongfulness of police in our country, and that's what that cop did. Was that right to do? I mean, that's pretty risky. It was pretty risky. I wasn't upset about that scene. I thought it was a very powerful scene in the game. Obviously, we lose their father. It's what triggers the power of Daniel, and we go from there. So, you know, I think it was, I guess it was necessary in terms of it to happen, but that was the first kind of example of them kind of playing that card. But we got references all throughout that this game is about, like, the immigrant, you know, obviously these people are from Mexico, they're immigrants, and some people in the game consider them illegal. They talk about building the wall a lot. In fact, the guy who captures him and puts him in the office, the one that's like the grocery store thing, he even says, like, this is why we need to build a wall. And I don't know. Like, to me, when the characters do that and the characters say those things, it's like they're making fun. It's like they're making fun of them. It's like, and not just making fun of them, but they're stereotyping. Funny enough, the people that are anti of the people that want the wall and all that stuff, they are the ones stereotyping. Because they kind of have made it so that it's just the big, you know, redneck, the hillbilly, whatever kind of people, and those are the people that think that, because that's really what the game portrayed in this episode, is those kind of people having that kind of attitude. And it's like, you know, that is the kind of mindset that really got everybody all in a ruckus 2 years ago when they really started characterizing people who voted for Trump, people who wanted things that Trump wanted and whatnot, and people who didn't. And funny enough, you know, people on the left, or people like Don't Nod, or however they want to make this, they don't say they stereotype, but ironically, they're the biggest stereotypers in the fact that they literally did that with their game. Again, they made those kind of characters the ones that think that, definitely putting, like, the onus on them, and, like, they're the ones, they're the only ones, or, like, they're the biggest ones that think that. And that's honestly, that's actually pretty racist, that's pretty stereotyping them. It's just funny that definitely is the mindset of a large section of the world now, is a lot of things are backward, even to the people that don't think that things things are backward, they still think it's backward. Again, here's the thing. I'm not criticizing people that are anti-Trump. But, you know, you have to watch out. You have to watch people that like Trump or don't like Trump can play your game. And, like, to attack that. And are they attacking it? No. I mean, it's just a character. And it's just an opinion. And they weren't playing it that much. And to give them credit or to be fair to them, the episode isn't about illegal immigration. And it isn't about building a wall. And it's not about, you know what I mean? So I get it. And I love the episode. And I did not like that part, the build the wall parts and the focus on the immigrants and all that stuff. I didn't like that part. But did that ruin the episode? No. I mean, the episode had so many really awesome parts. It had deeper emotions. It had deeper feelings. It had deeper themes, just like Life is Strange has. I mean, the game is known for themes. And it's just a little worrisome that this is a new theme that they're throwing in. And it's a dangerous one. It's political now. And you can do politics, whatever. And I know there's a large section of people that want politics like that in games. You know, I'm kind of on the fence about it, and to be honest, I would have said earlier that, like, before playing this, that I wouldn't necessarily mind, but after seeing it, I'm not the biggest fan of it. You know, I don't really need it, especially depends on how they do it, because you can really offend people when you do that, and Don't Nod's walking a line, especially because they're not even American. Like I said, they're French, so they're kind of playing the whole, this is what we maybe hear on the news, and we know how unbiased the news is, of course. So that's a little worrisome, because it's not like they're Americans. So it's not like they're getting their news or their what they think of us from actual us. They're getting it from whatever they perceive of us, which is a dangerous thing to do with any country ever. So, you know, there's just some iffy things. And that's really all I wanted to talk about. I wanted to, you know, just talk about what I perceived from that first episode. Fantastic episode. Really liked it. You can watch my review on it. There were just some things about it that I'm not a huge fan of. And we'll see. And I have a feeling that it'll continue in future episodes where they do this kind of stuff. So that's a little worrisome, but I'm interested to see how they kind of walk that line, if they get feedback from that and where that goes. So that's my thoughts on that. Let me know in the comments below, guys. What do you think of that topic? Again, these come out every single Wednesday at noon. So next Wednesday, we'll have a new topic. We'll be talking more about the first episode. I want to do a couple more videos on the first episode. Then we'll start talking about episode 2, and we'll go from there. This is going to continue on through all of Life is Strange 2. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope to see you on next week's episode.